Well, anyone within a certain radius of my house knows that I'm a hunter. When deer season's in, I deer hunt. When duck season's in, I duck hunt. When turkey season's in, I turkey hunt. The hog season is year round. There's a lot of people that pursue hogs or like to hunt hogs, and a lot of people like to bow hunt them. A lot of people like to gun hunt them. I know some people just trap hogs. I don't care anything about killing them, but I do dearly love to chase hogs with dogs. It's the thrill of a hunt, you know, and the excitement like you'll never get by shooting one with a bow, rifle, or in a trap pen. You know, when you turn your dogs loose and you've trained him from a little bitty, you know, you've got him when he was this big and he was a little pup, and you get him trained up and you get him running like he's supposed to and baying like he's supposed to, and you turn him loose and he tracks a hog, runs him down, gets him bayed up, and you ease up in there and you turn a bulldog loose, and it's so thick that you can't even stand up. Briars just this thick. Stand up and you crawl in there with a bulldog caught, and you put your hands on about a 300-pound boar and put a string on his foot. That's what I call exciting.
On today's show on Destination TQ, we're going hog hunting in Georgia without a gun.
Join John Wilson and his team TQ as they conduct business as usual. Whether it's outfitting from one of their lodges, sending clients to world-class destinations, or selling products stamped with their retail brand. All based down a dirt road at their southern lodge in Georgia. It's not just business to TQ. It's a lifestyle.
How you like her? I got a girl coming to get her today. You talking about Squeal?
I'm a hog hunter.
And a friend of mine got this for his his friend, his baby, and it got to growing, and his baby didn't want it anymore, so he brought it to me this week. But you're talking about Sweet. Her name's Charlotte.
Come here, Charlotte.
Ain't she sweet?
Here's a sweet little pig. Here's a sweet little pig.
Get back, Jay. We'll try to pick you to retrieve. Come on, Jay. All right, let's load us up some dogs and go hog.
All right, we going up there and make something Squeal.
Who's calling?
That be the Brooks family.
Getting their garments put on and getting them switched on, getting them all picking up satellite, and we're getting them on these dogs and making sure all these are going to work for us today.
Them vests have been cut a couple times. Save some dogs, though. They may hinder them a little bit, but they help more than they hinder, I believe.
You know what? We ain't caught no more big hams in a while.
We've
caught all the hams out, and we used to catch a bunch of them.
There was a bunch of big ham sows in him when we first started.
Yeah. When's the last ham we caught? I can't remember.
It's been several years, Tripp, since we caught a ham.
The old big poor boar we caught over yonder in the slough bed?
Yeah. That was the last.
That was the last stock.
They would white stripes on them, they can see them too good to shoot them.
that's a good target.
Destination TQ is proud to be partnered with Tire Kingdom Service Centers, Pennington Seed, there's no substitute for quality, The Furminator, best food plot implement on earth, Plantation Spoiled, Southern Outdoor inspired. This portion of Destination TQ is brought to you by Voodoo Deer Lure by Trophy Quest. Put a hex on them.
Just found this real big hog track here. You can see how big my hand is.
We can find these. We're going to have a good bay in here in a minute, maybe.
Get some calm dogs, Frank, boys.
We don't know how old it is. They could smell him a little bit where he wallowed right here.
One of the wonderful features about modern technology is these tracking collars that we have now. It's the good thing about it is when your dogs get gone and it tells exactly what he's doing. Like I said, you can look down there, and James has been with us enough times. We're tying a hog here, and I get up and stand up. First thing you do is look at your Garmin, and it shows a dog 1.1 miles bayed. So we get on the four-wheelers or trucks or even walk, run, whatever we do, have to get there. But you know right off the bat that your dog's got a hog bayed or what he's doing. You don't have to worry about him. And that is a wonderful thing this new technology has come up with.
Hey, we'll have to keep them dogs there quiet.
Took us most of the morning, but we have finally baited up one nice hog. Can you see his teeth there?
Yeah.
James, look what a boy. That duck as old as Joey is, I bet you.
There's one thing about it. He's caught hog.
He's caught now. But we got a dog the other direction. We hope he's baited. Did you get Jed?
I'm trying to catch him.
Come here, Jed. Then when you're ready, you'll get a little closer. Get a little closer. Then when you're ready.
One, two,
three. Look what the teeth on that rest. Hold that, Joey. I told him, I said, I bet he's old as Joey is. Teeth on him right there.
Yards. It's candy bay.
Trouble.
Something else got
over there now. That's your puppy.
It's not like a little candy.
If they'll do their job and run and get a hog bay, I'll do anything I can to get to them. It don't matter where they go, I'm going. Run him off in our river. He was fighting with him in the river. He went out on the other side, got on the sandbar, and they got to bait him over there. And I was contemplating swimming the river. It was really full. It was up to the top of the bank. And it was very dangerous. I had a life jacket back in my truck, but we were 3 miles from the truck, so I was contemplating getting to the four-wheeler. If they'd have kept him baited right there, I'd have went back to the truck. Got my life jacket, got upriver from him and swam across, but it was just too dangerous to swim that. If I did swim over there and got the hog caught, there wouldn't have been any way to get him back on our side of the river without a boat. So luckily, when they got to putting a little pressure on him, he decided not to go out on the bank on the side, he'd come on our side. And luckily, where they ended up getting him, it couldn't have been in a worse spot. Bank straight up and down, water. Luckily, there was a little ledge this deep right where the hog was bayed, and they got him stopped right there, and luckily I was able to jump down and get my hands on him before any of the dogs got hurt too bad.
Tripp's about to get him. Tripp's in the water. He's got him.
Hey, Leon. They fine right there. I'll get them when we get the hog up. They ain't, I don't think they're gonna swim the river.
Honda ought to sponsor us, at me.
Yeah, I believe so.
One, two, three! A little bit backward, but it's all right. Okay.
Closed captioning is provided by Millwood Lodge in Georgia. Come hunt with Team TQ. This portion of Destination TQ is brought to you by Black by Trophy Quest. Scent science for the professional hunter.
Well, I think it's quitting time.
Yeah, we about made all we can do. We made it and didn't drown.
Good, I thought he had you for a second.
Well, I was beginning to wonder at times.
He hit him a floppy stick.
He's fitting to act like a dolphin though.
After you do it, you know, you think about it, you say, that ain't the smartest thing you ever do. Uh-uh. But you don't think about it when your dog is down there.
Nope.
You know what day is?
What?
March 12th.
Day Uncle Gene died.
No. Yeah.
It just brought back a world of emotions. Right there where we tied the hog, there ain't no telling how many times me and Gene had stood right there on that riverbank and asked to cross the river when the river was lower. We right on the big sandbar where the hog was standing. Me and Gene's tied hogs right there before. I could tell you story after story about me and him hunting.
You know, when they go talking about Mr. Gene, I'm speechless.
That whole family, Joe and Gene, and you didn't get to meet Pug and David and you know, they're all different in a way, but they're all the same. I mean, like Gene and Joe, they're the most determined hunters I've ever been around. It's amazing. And when that family is gone, that bloodline ain't no more, you know. There needs to be more people like them, for real. He would have been here with us. He is now.
That's right.
He'd have been proud of that in right there now.
Yeah. He's probably cussing me for not getting him soon.
He got a fluffy tail, too.
Yeah, got a big tail just for him.
Let's see if we can get him to the truck,
y'all. Let's get him to the truck, get him unloaded.
Trip. He told me to be ready at 7. It is now 8:20. So I've been sitting out there waiting. I probably ate about 9 honey buns. But he got here and I guess we're about to start hunting soon.
It's gonna be our first victims right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Tony's gonna get them for us.
Oh yeah.
Do you think I had him a stick to whoop them down with?
He said they ain't got
just a case.
Mr. Gene Brooks told me smart people don't hog hunt, so I must fall in the dumb category because it's a lot of work. There's a lot of people get into it. A lot of these youngins get into it nowadays. They want to be hog hunters.
It's a thrilling hunt, but
when you really do it and do it right, it's a lot of work. Time them dogs hop off that tailgate, you just created yourself a lot of work.
I'm going in the creek with him now.
John invited us all up here to have a supper at the lodge one night, and actually Tony was here, and he showed a little interest in going hog hunting, and he was actually spending the night at the lodge, and we were going to hunt the next morning, so I invited him to hunt, and he took me up on it, surprisingly.
You know, we met Tony Mullis a few years ago when we were doing a show on Trophy Quest, and Tony since then has started his own nonprofit foundation called Amputee Outdoors, where he takes other wounded warriors on hunts. Tony served 2 tours in Afghanistan, and he is definitely one of our heroes.
But he's a tough little knocker. He's overcome a lot of difficulties in his life, and you don't know how much, when I say I appreciate it, how much I mean it. And I'm sure, you know, everyone else in this country feels the same way.
We think they got him baited up. We're gonna walk on in here to where they at. See if they got him baited.
Yeah, when there was a rodeo right here.
Good boy. We turned the dogs loose and they went down in here and hit a group of hogs and they've split, and we got some across the dirt road over here bayed, and we got 2 or 3 down in here working a hog trying to bay it up. So we're gonna go over here to the ones that's across the dirt road because they already got it bayed, so can't get it.
All right, we got some action going now. One hog bayed, one race going.
You want in there too?
Yeah, everything's in there.
Well, I don't hear nothing but old y'all.
One dog bayed.
Yeah.
You hear him now?
Yeah.
Yeah, they all good.
I'm gonna go over there too.
Get it caught, I'm gonna call you. Let you and Tony drive in with the four-wheeler. We'll let him tie it.
Destination TQ is presented by National Tire and Battery, Merchants Tire and Auto Centers, and by Tire Kingdom. For more information about adventures featured on Destination TQ, visit us online at destinationtq.com.
Chelsea, we're standing here in a food plot, and we've got our soil samples back. What are the things that we're supposed to look at on a soil sample, and what's the most important thing for us to look at?
Definitely the most important thing to focus on when you get your soil sample back is your pH. If you have a low pH, if it's around that 5.5 area, it's way too low. You're going to have to add some lime. If your pH is too low, you are not going to get the full potential out of your food plot.
So if we're looking to add some lime to our food plot, what's the best time of the year to be putting lime on a food plot?
Yeah, if you're focusing on producing a fall food plot, definitely apply your lime in the spring. It's gonna take around 3 to 6 months to really get that pH raised to the level you need it at, to its optimum level. So definitely apply in the spring. If you're looking at a spring food plot, just reverse that.
So you're saying optimal level. What's the optimum level that we like to see in our food plots?
For our pH level, we'd like to see that at a 6 to a 7 pH.
Definitely pH is very important, and folks, we just need to make sure we get a 6.5 pH to get the optimum benefits out of our food plots during the growing season.
Yep, I can't stress enough, lime, lime, lime.
We bait a big old boar out in this laid out pine field.
Give me that.
Got the bulldog in there to it. When he got a hold to him, I got in there, got him throwed down.
Good boy. I'm gonna keep him held at hand, Tony. Said he stabbed hogs before in Texas. If I can manage to hold him, I'm gonna let him ride his four-wheeler in here and let him tie one. He's a big old nice one. Get his back fin.
I was gonna set on that hog. I'd have sat on him to me and hear him one starved to death. To get Tony in there, but Joni got him on the phone, and Kevin drove him in. And
all right.
Ooh, yeah.
Come back.
Oh, you already got
come
around. Come around on my side, right here behind me.
Behind him, right here.
There you go.
Just get out any way you can. If you have to lay on it, hang him up. Get your foot right there. Open knot like I told you. Just a square knot like you're gonna tie your shoe. That's what we're gonna put his other leg in.
Heck yeah, good job. Woo!
We got him in there and he got to tie his first hog. He said he had stabbed some hogs with dogs before and he shot a couple, but he wanted to experience a tying a hog, and I'd have done anything in my power to let him do it.
It's pretty awesome. I ain't never been up on top of a hog that's still alive, so. Man,
he's a big one.
A big one too. Big old hemp. All right, James. This might be where the cameraman becomes assistant here. We might need some assistance.
All right.